I skip myself today. You got a fast song, I wanna skip it anyway. Might as well skip. Might as well skip. Go on and skip. Might as well skip.
All right, welcome back to the Skippables podcast. This is a show where we listen to the world's best bands and find their worst songs, aka their most skippable songs and their most notable songs. I'm your host, Gio Chapatazzi, and I am back with my co-host, Josh Lopez. What's up, Josh?
Ha ha hee hee ha ha ho. What's up, everybody?
Nice. What's up? How's it going? Have you been?
I'm chilling, dude. It was a rough day, but I feel like this band kind of had me gather those vibes, those chill vibes.
Yeah, okay. Good. And then, of course, the king of chill vibes is with us, Leon the Professional. Leon Cortez. What's up, Leon?
Hello, hello, hello. Sket it.
Dan's digging with
Keep
it.
With
cool,
Sket.
Cool.
I couldn't think of anything.
Eat shit, little pump.
Yeah. Fuck you, pump.
He's like irrelevant right now. He'll come after you.
Dude, yeah. Whatever.
He's desperate for some beef.
Let's do it. Bring him on the pod.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is it Lil Pro? Is that your like?
Lil
Pimp.
Pro, dude.
The Pro.
Yeah, I ain't a little.
Yeah.
Grown ass man. Yeah. Fucking little in.
Yeah, okay, you're not little. I mean, I guess the age of Lil is gone. It's over. Mm. I mean, there's new things
there's
now.
There's been whole waves of Lil. There's yeah. like early 90s Lil. There's yeah. early 2000s Lil. There's a whole generation
yeah.
of Lil.
So yeah, but jump on early. Grow out of that, age. Yeah.
Jump on it early. Lil Mr. Pro. Something like that.
That sounds
sure.
like Little Miss Sunshine, yeah. like yeah. his character. Yeah, Little Mr. Pro.
Okay, well, I mean, we have another chill vibes only type yeah. guy. We've had him on before. The guest demanded a full episode.
Yeah, he stormed in.
Mm-hmm. Much like he stormed other places. He stormed my garage.
Yeah, dude. Where were you?
Yeah, where were you? We have a special guest, Matt Lopez. Well, welcome back, Matt.
What's going on, guys? I'm happy to be here today. Feeling good. Feeling great. Let me fix my mic there.
Perfect.
Ooh. Happy to be back. Ready to talk about Sublime. I just downloaded these two or three albums into my head.
Nice.
Ready to hit it up.
Nice.
Yeah. Fucking yeah. robot, dude.
Boom.
Instead of like the whole like I know Kung Fu thing when Neo downloads it, he's just like, I know
Sublime.
Longboarding in Long Beach.
I know what I got.
Yeah. Our first cyborg.
Yeah, okay, yeah, so you did a Sublime for your choice this episode.
I did, and that was because, shall I say?
Yeah, tell me why.
Oh, because Leon said I could not do Frank Sinatra.
Frank Sinatra been on, that's a lot.
Damn.
I pulled my card, and you know, I said no. My fucking show.
You vetoed old Blue Eyes?
He yeah, everybody on, gets man. Screened through Leon.
Dude, I don't want to deal with the mafia, man.
True.
Bro, yeah, they would love to hear, you know, to hear Frankie been brought back.
No, but, dude, so, but like me talking about my least favorite Blue Eye song, dude, I'm gonna get murked.
Yeah. Hey, who the fuck is this guy?
Dealt with. Sleeping with the Fishes.
Yeah, so it's my mic, I'm sorry. It keeps on. So yeah, so after that I decided Sublime.
Yeah, Sublime is a fun band. We're like a local Southern California band. That's my dog Nico, hold on. Alright. Euthanize that motherfucker, dude, he's gone.
Thank God.
He's gone. Yeah. Rest in peace, Nico.
Everyone wants to come to the services.
Yeah. Don't come at me, Sarah McLachlan.
This was personal.
Yeah. He's in heaven with Lou Dog, I'm assuming.
Lou Dog.
Oh my
shout
God.
Out Gosh. Shout out to Lou Dog.
Dude, the oh dear. No.
I didn't really kill my dog.
Yes, he's asleep.
He's in a farm, okay.
He went to college.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so yeah, Sublime is like a local legend band. Like in Southern California, they're humongous. There are fanatics out here. And so I guess we should tread a little lightly, but also I think we all have pretty strong opinions about Sublime. Where do you fall on that, Matt?
Oh, I love Sublime. Gotta give it up. I know there's a lot of people who don't. But I think music is just so subjective. I'm not coming at it from like a lyrical or whatever kind of stance. I think it's just nostalgic. It was one of the first bands I listened to. And then, boom, I don't have, like, after listening to today, I was like, ah, there's probably not a lot of songs that I'd spend a lot of time listening on. But.
Yeah.
You know? It was good stuff. Yeah. And there's a lot of good stuff. Actually, I just remember my point. Sorry, I'm a little two sheets to the wind. A lot of good songs. Don't worry. But, Leon was pointing at my mic. It confused me. Small brain right
here. Yeah. Yeah. Leon's doing a little producer notes. But also, yeah, the music itself was, like, very interesting because I had a very hard opinion about this band, and then actually listening to it, it didn't really change much, like, at the end of the day, but, like, it was cool. It was better than I thought.
Yeah. I think that's, I think we all talked about it. Like, it's like a very, there's definitely a fans make things different for the band kind of situation.
Yeah, you're not desperate to jump on Sublime around here with the army of parka wearing people, you know, who stormed the Venice Beach. Then again, those were probably Sublime's people from the jump.
Yeah,
you know,
fucking freaks, dude.
This is why I feel
I think. And we also just get force fed a lot of Sublime growing up in Southern California.
I'll say something about Sublime. They're not a band that you can discover by yourself in Southern California. Like, you are force fed Sublime, like, nonstop.
Indoctrinated.
If you listen to the radio, you're listening to Sublime at some point.
Yeah, at some point you are, yeah.
So, you, like, your parents threw on What I Got when you were a baby.
Yeah, it's definitely shoved down the throat. That's probably why it's in my head. Fuck, they got me.
Exactly. And it's fun. I mean, it's definitely a lot more jumbled up than I realized as an entire discography. But, like, yeah, it's fun. I get it. It's, like, nice, breezy, fucking punker type stoner music.
Yeah, laid back, like, no one gives a shit kind of music. Done by people who were living the lifestyle, like, the whole time. Like, good for them. But also, I don't know, man. Like,
yeah,
not my thing.
Not my thing either.
Never my thing. And now you have, like, an entire culture surrounded, like, around this band and this guy.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, they're, like, glorifying him and stuff. And, like, I don't, he had a beautiful soul.
Definitely right? A justified character, for sure, Bradley Noel. You know, Noel. I don't know. Noel?
We'll call him Noel. Noel. Yeah, sure.
What did he do?
He was the lead singer, yeah.
No, I know. What was the shit part?
Oh, I mean, just, like, being, like, the lead singer of this band. that's probably the biggest one.
Shit, I thought he, like, slapped somebody or something, like, slapped his girlfriend or something.
If you take any of his, like, lyrics seriously,
yeah,
then he was, like, a real vindictive, jealous man. But, like, that he could be writing from characters, and he's written a lot of songs where, like, they are stories.
Mm.
So I don't know. I you don't want to peg anything on him, but, you know, like, we'll just say that, like, this is a guy that probably wasn't a perfect person.
Yeah.
And is now, like a hero. And, like,
dude, that's funny. Who knows? Everybody.
It's
like Cobain. It's another Cobain, dude. in my opinion.
So three albums, dude.
Dude, Chris Brown's still alive.
Chris Brown is not dead.
Fucking, yeah.
What?
Who, you know, I mean, there's some other people I get. Let me think, yeah. I guess you guys are right. Let's see what's going on.
No, okay.
Right. Yeah, Chris Brown.
Chris Brown.
We're Googling. Nope.
Other still dead alive. Celebrities.
Is he supposed to be
Bob
dead?
Oh, wait.
Oh, yeah.
Is he supposed to be dead?
Somebody didn't do their job.
A little jumped up. He's supposed to be dead. Here. I know. Fuck.
Mm-hmm.
But, okay. All right. I see that. Oh, sorry about that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We just checked. Chris Brown is alive.
Yeah.
He's alive.
He's alive and well.
I could have sworn.
He's doing Instagram Live right
Damn
now.
Damn you, Mandela.
Damn you, Mandela.
Yeah.
Just the one man Mandela. He's dead.
Yeah.
He's dead. But I don't know. Yeah, like you're saying, that was my experience with Sublime.
It's same. Everywhere.
Yeah. Growing up, it's on K-Rock. My parents probably played it.
Mm-hmm.
Going to the beach, you're guaranteed to hear it here. I haven't lived anywhere else, so as far as I know, they're the biggest band in the whole world.
Yes, they really are.
Bigger than the Beatles.
Yeah, they're huge. I hear them more than the Beatles out in the streets.
Yeah, I don't know. It's the same. I think we've all just kind of, like, living in Southern California, you just, like, absorb it through osmosis at some point.
Yeah.
And then, like, if you're one way, you grow to love it. And if you're, like, I think three of us, you kind of grow to despise it, maybe. And, like, just get sick of it. Just get so sick of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but actually, like, it was interesting. It wasn't terrible.
Mm-hmm. Right. Because, like, we're listening to the whole discography. We're doing all the albums, and it's only three. So, like, it's not much, but also, like, they're not playing all the albums. They're playing, like, five songs in rotation, five or six songs. So hearing the rest of it, like, puts it in context, and it, like, makes those good songs, like, make way more sense in the album, you know? Like, it's... And then, like, they have, like, reprises, and, like, they sample a lot of shit. So, well, it's really fun to see the rest of what they did alongside of their hits. Because their hits are good if you, like, wipe your memory of, like, the last 30 years, you know?
I feel like listening to it in sequence, I definitely felt the hits more, you know? Like, doing all of Robin Da Hood and mm-hmm. then hearing What I Got, I was like, oh, whoa, yeah, like, this is a good song.
And, yeah, and I mean, and it's a mix of what they were doing.
In the moment.
Exactly. Yeah, I mean, it's fine.
You heard it here, folks.
He loves it.
I love it.
He loves What I Got.
That's my other tattoo on my other knee.
Weezer and Sublime.
Does it say, do you have a Sublime tattoo?
No.
Oh, I was like, damn.
He's going to. That's his next one.
On my knee, it just says, it's What I Got.
What I Got.
Maybe
tell the ladies right there.
The Weezer W, like, starts off the What I Got. What I Got. Oh, my God.
I'll get, like, the Slipknot S.
My cousin had the Slipknot S on his forearm.
That's had cool. it? So he had got rid of it?
He got rid of it.
How did he get laser it off, or he covered it?
He covered it up with, I think it was, like, the visor image of, like, somebody snowboarding or something.
Oh, ho, ho.
Yeah.
Upgrade.
Shout out.
Upgrade.
Shout out. I mean, he might have lasered it at this point.
Does he snowboard, or is he just a big fan?
He used to snowboard. Okay. Him and his dad used to go to, like, Mammoth all the time and snowboard. That was, like, their thing.
But was he good?
No. I mean, not like...
No, he was terrible.
You know, he's not Johnny Tsunami.
Yeah, that's a wild tattoo to get, man.
So he probably did listen to a little bit of Sublime.
Probably.
At some point.
Probably.
He was living that lifestyle.
Absolutely. I mean, he lived in, like, Orange County, Anaheim.
Whoa.
It's close enough.
Yeah.
Close enough
he
to...
He loves it.
Yeah, he definitely loved it. I mean, people...
Huge fan.
Yeah. Like, I really want to stress this. Like, when I say fanatics, like, I mean, like, truly, like, you say any band is, like, is bad, and especially Sublime, and, like, people are going to get, like, they're going to think you're a bad person.
That's true.
You know?
Yeah, that's true. I was definitely one of those people.
They won't fuck with you if you don't like it.
Oh, you don't like Sublime? What? Yeah. It's just because there's something to say.
And I feel like just them as a whole, they're... I fucking forgot where I was going. I'm also on the same wind that Matt's on.
We're going to take Josh out for a little break.
Yeah, I got to go pee.
Come back with a couple black guys.
I got to go for a walk.
Yeah, I don't know. They're a stony band. And, you know, we all got faded to commemorate. And
I was like, I want to know what it's like.
Definitely, you know, if it's your first time smoking weed, like Josh's, you know.
And mine.
And Matt's. <Yeah.
laughs> I feel Sublime.
But also, they do a lot more than just weed. And that's where we split off, me and Sublime.
I mean, you can definitely hear that through their music. Like, it feels like a fever dream in a lot of times. Mm-hmm. I think it's pretty good. I was kind of surprised. I don't know how much Sublime I'm going to listen to after this episode, but I won't say that they're a bad band.
Okay.
You know, I won't say that they're, like, a terrible band, because even if it's not the normal sort of music I would listen to, I can tell, like, damn, this guy was fucking on one. And, like, these crazy ass thoughts got, like, recorded, you know, in the moment. So
interesting. I'll save my final thoughts for a little bit later on my full opinion. But I will say, I started off thinking this is going to be really bad, and I really don't want to do this. And I was okay with it at the end. So it wasn't that terrible.
Yeah.
It wasn't that terrible.
It kind of runs adjacent to what I'm into.
Yeah. I was going to say.
It does, yeah.
This so is like,
there's a lot of stuff, and I was like, oh, fuck, okay.
They would be your friend, dude. Yeah. Like, if you saw them.
Well, I think if I was like, a teenager in the 90s, I would probably be into them.
Yeah. Because, like, they like everything you like. The whole, like, their thanks song, they're mm-hmm. thanking all these bands.
Yeah.
A lot of the bands we like.
Yeah.
Strange.
But why not now?
Doesn't he say crass?
He does.
He says fucking crass, dude.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Why not now?
Why not now?
That's a great question. You know
what changed? Why can't you like a band at that time?
It's kind of cheesy.
Yeah, But he's a guy who fucking is like living on the fringes, like with addiction and stuff. He probably doesn't know that he's gonna, you know, he didn't even survive. He didn't live to see the success of the final album. You know, he died before its release. So.
Yeah, like 2 months before or something like that.
So he was like, probably like, this shit is not gonna last. Like, I have to like, you know, run through what I got. What I got.
Yeah, so
they could all remember that?
We can all remember that.
Yeah, and we do. And we have, and people have made like a religion, you know, out of Sublime. They're still touring. They're still playing songs.
Oh, fuck Rome.
Mostly in Italy, right?
With Rome, yeah.
Yeah, right? Mostly they got a whole gig in downtown Rome. Rome.
You don't like Rome guy?
No, dude. I don't know who that guy thinks he is coming back from Sublime with Rome.
Yeah. I mean,
when that first happened, I was like, are you kidding me right now?
You don't think it's more of the drummer and the bassist's fault? I mean,
I would do it too.
Yeah.
You would do
and
it?
And then people would fucking hate you.
Yeah, I know. Fuck, and I'm like, fuck you. I'm in Sublime.
Sublime and that.
Sublime with Matt.
I can sell my kids. I was in that
part. Yeah.
Fuck. No, you fucking weren't.
I know. Fuck you. Rome, I don't know. You know, he almost sounds like Bradley, but just a little different, you know? A little
right.
I haven't heard any of that. We should make it clear. We only heard the first three, or for this episode, we listened to the first
three Bradley stuff.
The Bradley albums. Like the real Sublime.
Yeah.
You see, I probably see Sublime with Rome like you guys see Sublime.
I say Sublime is Bradley, though, dude. Yeah, because, the bass kind of slaps sometimes, but, like, for the most part, it's just him going nuts and then tripping out on him.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. I can see that.
Yeah, I don't know. Bradley is his own, like, you know, mythology in himself, and now that they're, like, living beyond him, that's, like, the only thing they can cling on to, like, probably make a lot of money. Like, they're probably making a shit ton of money. So, I don't blame them, but also, like, I'm never gonna go see it. But, like,
if I got tickets,
Burners would,
free tickets.
Oh, you'd go? Tickets.
Someone,
would you go? Because
someone's trying
tickets?
To get rid of
them? I mean, yeah, I would go if I was invited to go.
Like, you got like, free tickets, you're let's go.
I'll go anywhere. Mm-hmm. Give me a ticket.
Shit.
Yeah, but I mean, no, if they're paying at the LA County Fair, I would go. That'd be fun. Earth, Wind & Fire, and then like them or something, you know, like
I saw
very
X.
cool. At the fair?
At X and Roland's band, dude.
Oh my
god. Wow.
Yeah, it was nuts.
I saw Migos.
That's crazy to see it. Migos.
OC Fair.
Shit.
Yeah, Migos at the LA County Fair.
Oh, that was huge. I remember
it was
that.
Cool. I saw toddlers going fucking nuts, dude. Loved it. Let's take a quiz now. It's time for a quiz.
We should do the quiz. All right, guys. Number one, where was the album 40 Ounce to Freedom recorded? A, at Record Plant Recording Studios in LA. B, at Cal State University. Or C, at a local bar before opening.
C, the bar.
A.
Cal State.
Guys, it was a Cal State.
Thank you. Long Beach. It's got to be Cal State, Long Beach.
Cal State Dominguez Hills, dude. They actually snuck in after hours. Like, it closed at 9, and they would, like, break in afterwards and, like, duck the guards. And they recorded it until 5 a.m.
Wow.
And later Bradley, like, said that it was probably, like, $30,000 worth of recording time that they just, like, jacked. And, like, they would be ducking. Like, supposedly the guards would, you know, be checking all the rooms, and they would just, like, duck out, you know?
Damn, that's insane.
Isn't that cool? Crazy. That's cool.
Especially making an album like that.
That's wild. That's wild. Yeah. Good for them, dude.
That's super cool.
What's the statute of limitations? Can we get them on that? Can we call the cops on them? They admitted
it. I cracked the case. Yeah. I actually cracked the case. I had to like find out what they did.
Yeah.
I was like, these acoustics are
crazy.
I
broke into the LAPD, got their files in order to solve this case.
All right. Number two. Who was singer Bradley Knowles' favorite rapper? A, Just Ice. B, what the fuck? Curtis Blow. I misspelled it, sorry. Or C, Big Daddy Kane.
C, Big Daddy Kane.
Yeah, I'll say Kane.
Is it A?
Just Ice. Dude, oh, Matt is on fire.
Just Ice.
Yeah. KRS-One, like, I guess, was the producer of a couple of those records and stuff, so that kind of explains that connection.
Okay.
But he brought in...
I don't even know how.
Yeah.
He brought in the Just Ice album, the degenerate one, to K-Rock. He was like a guest DJ and was just like, oh, put on whatever fucking track. It's fucking gold. You know, like, don't worry. But so, yeah, Just Ice.
So, yeah, take
number
that.
Number three, and scene.
Number three, when was Sublime's first show? A, Valentine's Day, 1989. B, Cinco de Mayo, 1990. Or C, 4th of July, 1988.
4th of July, 1988.
Yeah, 4th of July, 88.
I gotta say 4th of July, 1988.
Wow. Guys, yeah, a unanimous correct answer. Yeah. It just makes a lot of sense being from Long Beach. So they their first show was at a little club, and they sparked what's called the Peninsula Riot, where the crowd spilled out and was, like, trashing cars and buildings and stuff, and seven people got arrested.
Whoa. Why? Was it that bad?
Yeah. They just played. Was it that bad? There was a goddamn, we want a refund!
Yeah, they're pissed.
Number four, who is the artist that painted the cover art for the album 40 Ounce of Freedom? Or To Freedom. A, Ernie Estevez, B, Opie Ortiz, or C, Pico Pacheco.
Are these real names?
Guys. Are these the birds from that the Tiki Tiki Room?
I'll go Pico Pacheco.
Yeah, that's definitely best phonetically sounded.
What's B?
Opie Ortiz.
Opie Ortiz is my guy.
I want to say A then, just to be the fucking...
Guys, Opie Ortiz.
Oh, wow. Nice. Fuck, Opie.
Dang, Leon.
A name that people don't use anymore. They should.
Yeah, of course. I guess he's from Long Beach, of course.
Opie?
One of their local homies.
Okay.
Number five. How did Sublime know Raleigh from the Raleigh soliloquies on Robin the Hood? A, a neighbor of a friend. B, a local homeless man that would wander into their practice garage. Or C, a random drunk Brad met at a bar.
Gotta be B.
Yeah.
C.
It's very creative. B.
C.
Guys, it was a neighbor of a friend. Yeah. His name was Raleigh Theodore Sakers. There was a bunch of rumors, I guess, back in the 90s on, like, who he was. Mm-hmm. And when I was looking through Reddit at them, one was he was the guy. People were theorizing in the 90s that he was the guy who first gave Bradley a hit of H.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
The crazy guy who was like,
yeah,
like,
because
I'll,
nobody,
I'll kill you, fucker, like, I'll kill, you know, like,
yeah, yeah, because I guess on the liner notes they just have, like, featuring Raleigh whatever, you know. Oh. So, like, I guess they were just like, oh, he was tripping out during this album, he was him, you know.
Okay.
But yeah, god damn it,
someone go to snopes.com and check if that's true.
I cracked all these cases, cracked guys.
It. you'll see the what do you call it, the byline, Josh Lopez right there, cracked it.
All right, number six. How did the band get more shows in their early days? A, they traded club promoters' drugs to get onto shows. B, they used a pseudonym to get their name out more. Or C, they boasted about a fake label they were on.
Hmm. Yeah, and B, the John Barron. They call in and they're like, oh, I've heard about Sublime. They're the best band ever. Like,
C.
They faked it.
Yeah, C.
C. Yeah. I guess they said that they were on Skunk Records.
Good imagination, man.
Yeah. I was there, dude.
What could they be?
Mandela again.
What could their name be? But yeah. They,
Skunk
they
Records.
They said they were on Skunk Records and then later released their first album on Skunk Records. And number seven, how did current Sublime members meet new singer Rome Ramirez?
Fuck that guy. Just
A, Rome wrote them a very intimate and touching letter. B, B, Rome met them while working as an audio engineer. Or C, Rome is Bradley's illegitimate son.
Ugh. No way. That's no way.
I'm going to say B.
All these cases, guys.
I'm going to say the engineer. Say. He's the engineer.
B, yeah.
B.
Guys, he was an engineer.
Yeah.
Okay. I had a really strong theory that he was the illegitimate son, but it, no, I yeah. didn't have the evidence.
That would almost make it all okay.
How old would... I mean, I don't know. I'm sure Bradley fucked when he was, like, a young, young boy.
12.
Okay. 12. So, yeah, that is it. Matt is the winner with 4.
I cannot believe that.
Leon gets 3, so and Gio racked up
Santeria
his 2.
Santeria under the table. Dude.
That's wild.
Fucking cheater.
With my phone. And I won last time, too. Very surprising. It's getting good.
Interesting. Interesting.
Luck of the Lopez.
Luck of the Lopez.
Yeah, the Lopez. It's funny how a Lopez is administering the quiz, and a Lopez is winning.
You guys cousins or what?
If there was a large enough family reunion, I'm sure I would see every Lopez I've ever met. You know?
Because I'm still meeting cousins that I, like, have never met, you know, mm-hmm. or, like, at, you know, a family reunion or, like, a funeral. I'm just like, oh, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. I'm so sad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fair. Lopez. Wow. Great quiz. Great job, Matt. Let's take a quick break and we'll be right back. And we're back. I skip two songs in the morning, skip two songs at night. Hello, hey, skip two songs in the afternoon. Ho, ho, it makes me feel all right. Come on now. I smoke two, no, not smoke, it's skip.
I skip two songs in the morning.
Well, you know what? It's time for the Skippy Awards, everybody.
Yeah. That's what everybody's here for, dude. Everybody just skipped.
Yes.
Everybody just skips the whole intro to this.
Right here, 34 minutes.
How ironic.
Or so. Yeah. Okay, so... The Skippy Awards, very serious. We're going to give out some awards. They're not all bad songs, not all good songs, but we will be finding the most skippable song.
Yeah, stick around for that one.
Skipping.
Stick around. Skip to that part. But before you skip, let's get the first award out of the way. The Elizabeth Frazier, a.k.a. the most unintelligible vocal line, and this is something that you heard. Elizabeth Frazier, famous from the Cocteau Twins. So who wants to go first to show everybody how it's done?
I'll go first. Because I think this needs to be said right up at the top. Bradley can speak really fast.
Yes.
And it comes out kind of incoherently sometimes. And I couldn't really choose one. Like, every time I would choose a song for this, I'd be like, well, there's that other one. So I compiled a couple of songs where he does the thing that I am talking about. And I think it just speaks for itself.
Okay. I met her sleep, but if I buy, give it up, Whoa,
that's pretty much every song I could give it to, because he's got that, like, it almost adds to the rhythm.
Make goes, that my ringtone, dude.
Yeah.
Send me that. I want to make that my ringtone.
That's good, huh?
Yeah, make a TikTok, guys.
That was really good. I feel like you took, like, maybe some of ours. So if you did, how dare you?
Yeah. I don't think saw you guys' stuff from a mile away.
Yeah.
Well, I actually, mine's not even Elizabeth Frazier. Word, I just...
What?
I'm just doing whatever I want to do because I'm like that.
Excuse me.
The Elizabeth Frazier Award, yeah.
I'm a fucking punk, man.
Yeah.
Thanks, just because it's fucking cool.
Thanks is yours, okay.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe nice. Some of the people are incomprehensible because they're like nobodies.
Yeah, 134.
Like, he's like, hey, Sam in Arcata. And then he's like, later on, he's like, hey, Liz in Arcata. It's like, wait, you couldn't group them together? Like, Sam and Liz? Like, are they not
friends?
They
didn't know each other, yeah.
Miss J, the Johnsons. Yeah, Mrs. J, what's up? Yeah, 134.
Okay.
Stands Martini with his 40 ounce in hand. To Jai Dodds and his son, Kristen. I gotta say, thank you. The scum, hard as smoke and cheap as wood. The scum at and the vandals. How about HR for enough inspiration, enough respect? Hey, Nick Tweet, Joanne and Carolyn. Hey, I gotta say what's up to fucking Snow and Bam Bam and all the Eastside Stoners. Thanks out to Sean Stern, the Kenji Easley Project, Steve Zapata.
Yeah, dude. How old is Martini? And did we see him out in the sun?
Yeah, no, we didn't.
No, we did not.
He's extremely skinny for the listeners as well.
Mm-hmm.
Is this man a fucking vampire, dude?
Could be.
He's
shout out
for those who are listening to our show for the first time. Martini was our guest last. Yeah,
last guest
last week.
Past guest. Yeah. He was at, and he likes 40 ounces. You know, I've seen him drink that. So, you know,
what a coincidence.
Martini.
Yeah.
Martini, he's got a shout out from him. And like back in the day, I do remember Martini being a big Sublime fan.
Okay, along with the Beastie Boys. And the Sublime are really big Beastie Boy fans too.
Big 40 proponents too.
Yeah, and 40 proponents. I mean, they're all, yeah, the Brass Monkey.
They're all about the 40. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. 40. Martini's seen them all.
Yeah.
He was there for
wow,
all
he's
of
been
it.
There. Yeah, Mandala, dude. Wow. Okay, so that's your thanks. I guess maybe I'll go next. We'll leave Matt last as the last and best. So mine is going to be DJs at 135. You're my dumb DJ. Long I'm in it. I have to make it, but I ain't no freak. Cut the man, you know, with the tempo.
Yeah, that's a good one.
So he says something about grilled cheese, and then he says something about anal.
Yeah.
And then the guy laughs.
Yeah.
But I looked up the lyrics, and he says, my brother Eno. So
he doesn't say anal.
He doesn't say anal. He says Eno, like Brian Eno.
Oh. Well, that's he does shout out Eno and thanks.
So so
Eno and something, and they're having their new baby. Congratulations.
Okay, well, maybe Eno is a friend or something then.
Is actually his brother.
Yeah, he's like an actual brother of his or something. Maybe, because I read it I looked up the lyric in two different places, A to Z and then Spotify. And both of them, like, you know, in A to Z, they had I-N-O, and then Spotify had E-N-O. So I'm not sure what's what.
Maybe it was just homies with Brian Eno.
He might be.
I mean, he could have taken inspiration from him. There's a lot of, like, I know Brian Eno's very fancy with them pedals. He's working them pedals.
Oh,
and there's
true.
A lot of parts in Sublime where he just kicks on that distortion for a sec. Mm-hmm. They space it out. You know,
yeah,
a lot of delay.
Out.
Yeah, it's very dub-inspired, too, so who knows?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Interesting. I don't know. So that whole thing about the grilled cheese and the anal, who knows? Could be anything, but definitely... These guys know how to fucking party.
That's your comment. That's a party, huh?
Yeah. Yeah,
party fetish.
That's a party for me. Yes, please. All right, so Matt, what is your Elizabeth Fraser award?
All right, well, so it's supposed to be a specific, like, lyric?
Yeah, like a part in a song that
Or what do you have?
Just, yeah, just right. Give me whatever.
I just got Shame in Them Game. I don't got a specific area, but you drop it anywhere.
All right.
You don't know what the fuck they're saying.
Is this a song they sing in Spanish?
No.
Oh, okay.
I would have caught on to that one.
Shit.
I kind of hear it a little bit. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck they were saying there. Shame and Them Game for sure. And then a lot of...
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah, guessing, yeah. Very well done.
you did the assignment, and I didn't do it, so yeah.
He understood the assignment.
Understood the assignment.
The Elizabeth Fraser has turned into, like, also Leon gets to show another song he likes.
Yeah, I like the song. Award. No, but that was good, though. And, you know, like, they do have that type of song where they're, like, kind of dubby.
Mm-hmm.
And Bradley does his best, like, interpretation of that, like, sound that he's going
What's
for.
Dubby?
Dude just tries to sound like HR.
Yeah.
What's dubby?
Like, I guess, like, just like a reggae sound.
Oh, okay.
With, like, the, you know, the delayed vocal and, like, the bass, like, doop 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 boop,
yeah.
Boop, you know, that kind of thing. Not fast.
Yeah.
You know? But okay, great, Elizabeth Fraser. Let's go to the top bop. This is the best song in your opinion. Your favorite can be the single, can be, you know, like a song that you like just because you like it. Any of the above. So who wants to go top bop? Who wants to go first?
Matt?
I'll do top bop. Out of these three albums, okay, and I know there's a lot of controversy here about this, but what I got. And that's because... It was an original, you know, it was OG. It's one of the first songs I think I memorized, and that's why. So, what I got.
What I got.
And that's all I got.
How was that?
What I got. I don't fly with my dogs, whatever the fuck.
I thought you memorized it, man.
I don't fly.
I don't get angry. I thought you had it memorized. What
happened? It's been some time.
I remember it.
I like to put my own little, you know, vibe to it.
Oh, yeah.
Razzle dazzle.
I don't fly when my dog runs away.
bad omen. Don't fly.
And then you got a time for that or any time?
Oh, shoot. You drop that down.
Any time.
No, you know what? Is that is that where he goes? Boo, 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 doo, boo.
Yeah.
Drop it on that part.
Yeah.
That's the fucking money part.
Exactly at that part. Here we go.
I never heard you.
Rise into the street. Light me up that cigarette. And I'll strap shoes on my feet. Got to find the reason. Reason things went wrong. Got to find the reason why my money's all gone. I got a damnation. I could still get high.
can play the guitar like a motherfucking riot.
That's it right there.
We found it.
It's a classic.
Oh man, dude.
It really is. That, I mean, can you guys name any like movies or commercials Shrek, with right? that?
It's no, not in Smash Mouth, bro.
No.
Shrek.
My swamp is what I got.
Yeah, I didn't remember that. Donkey.
I can't think of a specific commercial that this is tied to. No,
I just feel like it's one of those songs that's just like everywhere. It's ubiquitous.
It's just on our, it's just in the radio in Southern California, man.
Yes. Is that just my whole circle of influence?
Yeah.
Well,
it's just like that's where we are. Like that's like other places fetishize us by purely by this band. Like this, is their song. Like understanding of our '90s was this band.
100%. I have a funny story about this song. I went camping one time and we were on a Greyhound. I'll make this really quick. So, like, sitting behind us on the Greyhound is this, like, family that, like, I'd say nicely, definitely, like, you know, nomad kind of people. You know?
Burner,
like, travelers. Or... Yeah, burner, hasher kind of people, right? Hell, like, getting faded, like, every time we stopped, that kind of thing. So, like, homies, like, you know, I was also getting faded, too, right? But, like, we're chilling. They have, like, a toddler little girl. She's, like, at some point very chill, but later on in the night, she gets, like, kind of whiny and starts crying. So the dad cradles her, and he starts singing What I Got. But instead of, like, the cigarettes, he's like, you know, give me some candy bars and strap shoes on my feet. You know, like, being really sweet about it.
Mm-hmm.
So we're listening to him, like, serenade his daughter. And he gets to, like, and I can play the guitar like a motherfucking riot. He's really loud. And, like...
Forgot to censor himself.
Like, whoops, like...
Dude, he's a fucking rebel, dude. Yeah. That's what he fucking wants.
You know, wherever, if he's out
felt
there...
It. He felt it.
The daughter's probably old enough to be a listener now. Hey, yeah, they sang it together.
Despite that song being overplayed and, you know, all the stuff that we're saying, when he says, I can play the guitar like a motherfucking riot and goes to the dorky-ass solo.
Dorky.
Come for me if they want, dude. That shit is so dorky, man.
It is very, like, Steve and Miller
band. He, like, rips on other songs. He can play guitar. He's like, boop, boop.
Yeah, that's really funny. yeah, that's a good song, though.
That's like, golden.
Give you credit on that. It's a fine song.
Yeah.
What about you, Leon? What's your top bop?
My top bop is Badfish.
Ooh, Leon.
That's my top bop. Dude.
What?
Is it your top bop,
too? All three of our top bops. Basic.
This is the first time this has ever happened.
Did you just call us basic?
I'm just saying that's basic. Badfish? Everybody and their mother, man.
Dude, fuck, dude. You have What I Got.
Now that's an overplayed song, dude.
Holy moly. I mean, oh, all right, I'll take it.
I mean, it's a great song, don't get me wrong.
Yeah. But just, I think one is clearly more basic.
It's very Milk Toast.
Clearly.
Milk Toast.
Oh my god.
Just no, it's good. It's good.
Okay.
You guys are good.
You guys are good. You guys are good in my book. I don't care what they say about you.
Yeah, I don't know. I have fucking
just hit it.
Just hit it.
Yeah, do it.
I dive deep when it's 10 feet overhead. Gravity underneath my bed. I'm weak. Won't somebody get me up with this
ring? It's a good song.
It's good.
It's a good song.
Yeah.
The intro with the dudes talking.
Yeah.
It has that, like, yeah.
It's like a commercial for California.
Oh, it's so good.
As you're walking through Venice,
yeah,
the street, I don't know, the main street with the fucking sign.
Shout out, Rivers Cuomo, sweater song.
Yeah.
Dude, yeah.
That intro talking kind of thing. There's just something about, like, that show, like, recording of just people being like, hey, like, what's up, dude? Like,
mm-hmm. Like, this song is nice.
It's so sweet.
Thank you, bro. I don't know. It's really cool. I was gonna say this is like a hidden gem, because like, but it's not a hidden gem. Like it was just like I forgot about this song. Yeah, I always forget about this song. And like when I heard it, I was like, whoa! Like, what a rip!
It hit. Yeah, it's solid.
He's definitely going through stuff there.
It's solid. It's there. I'm just saying.
Wow. And we all chose it.
Yeah, wow.
That's great. That's the first time that's ever happened.
Yeah. That's huge. That's huge.
We all love this song.
There's fireworks. There's fireworks happening right now in the background. That's because we all chose the same song.
Next time we ever go on a road trip,
this
is going on.
Only the song.
CD. Yeah. Lord knows I'm
weak. All three of us.
Fist bumping. We can harmonize it, dude. Quartet.
And then Rusted Root.
Yeah. You the siren? Yeah. All right, so that's all of our top ops. Wow.
Leon, I'm just picturing.
Yeah. All right, so next is the Morrissey Award. This is the worst political or social take that Sublime or Bradley ever made. I mean, this is the 90s. Maybe we should preface that, but hey, this is the 90s. You know, it's different. But this fool is a straight-up scumbag. In his lyrics, straight-up scumbag. And so let's see who has what dirt on Sublime or Bradley. Who wants to go first on this one, Josh?
I actually chose to give away my Morrissey Award.
Give it away now?
Yeah. To present, adjacent to Red Hot Chili Peppers, the Eminem Stan Award.
Whoa.
For this award goes to the band for having the worst fan base in general, and just like deferred me from ever listening to them. They're really not that bad, honestly, to people who are just gonna honestly bingeable. I listened to it twice, all together in a row, and I never listen to stuff like for the podcast. I usually listen out of order, dude. Mm-hmm. You can binge this, no problem. It all sounds like it like came out within like 2 years or something,
quick.
You know?
It's quick, for sure.
Yeah. A bunch of songs, but all like 2 minutes.
And they repeat. The first album gets repeated in the second and third album.
Yeah.
Like, they just kind of pick and choose from like the first
different
album.
Different recordings and stuff like that.
All that being said, where Stan comes in is all of the people in this area that have made me not want to listen to this band by like idolizing them so much.
Yeah.
I don't always hate a bandwagon, but, you know, I'm dodging traffic if there's some out there on the road, you know?
Yes. I mean, and here's the thing, and we haven't talked about it yet, and I think you might have mentioned it first, but the artistry, the logo is so tacky, and people have this fucking sun tattooed on their fucking lower backs, and, it's just a bad, for me, it's bad design. I don't like the way it looks. It looks very, like the sad looking sun.
Yeah.
Looks so dopey. He looks like Eeyore.
It's the shit that Henry Rollins has on his back, right?
Does he?
Yeah. I fucking love Sublime.
Yeah.
Sublime fucking sun.
And that's a part of it, is that like they, you know, that's like, that's their calling card. You see people with fucking tattoos with that shit on. So I don't know. And that's just an issue with like,
pick it up with Opie Ortiz on that one.
Yeah, dude. Opie.
Fucking guy.
Drop the ball on that one, dude.
Cool. Don't name
him. Dopey Ortiz, dude.
Dopey
Ortiz. Fucking got him, dude. You, dude. Change your logo.
I mean, that's ass probably face. I'm honestly trying to put myself in the like mindset of people doing heroin and recording reggae music every day. And, I'd probably feel like that fucking sun.
That sun is perfect. It
makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, that's a good point. That's a great point.
You're not living that life, dude.
Okay, so
that's a life.
All right, not so worth you did a you give it you gave it away now.
I gave it away. Give it away. Wait, and they fucking shout out "Fight Like a Brave."
No way.
I can't remember the name of the song. We'll find it later, and I'll send it to you.
Okay. Okay. Interesting. Very cool. These guys are name droppers to the max, dude. Yeah. For sure. For sure. Okay. What about you then? What's your Morrissey Award, Leon?
My Morrissey Award is going to be "Mary," at a minute.
That's a good one.
It's kind of a fucked up song.
When we got to the pad, Mary baby started calling me her dad. Yes, she gave me head. We could not find the damn bed. 15 years old plus one, hotter than a microwave oven.
This This guy says 15 years old plus one and hotter than a microwave oven.
How old was he when he wrote the song?
Oh, come on, dude. Fuck
matter, dude. If he's 17, that's a song. But yeah, that's a little weird, though, if it's otherwise.
A little gross.
It's like the Beatles, too. The fucking, she was just 17.
You know what I mean.
Yeah, if you know what I mean.
You fucking creep.
That's weird. You're a little wild.
They even said that shit, you know what I mean. Yeah, dude. Okay, so, very well done. It exemplified what I was saying when I kind of said Bradley is a kind of a creep. Dude is writing these songs. I can I go next? Is that okay?
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna go let next. I'm gonna
let
show another example. I'm gonna let it burn.
Let it burn.
One of his big hits, Santeria. This guy is like a vindictive, jealous ex-boyfriend who is gonna like murder this guy named her new Sancho, and it's fucked up. And I don't think people talk about it enough. I had $1 million, but I'd spend it all if I could find that Hannah in that Sancho that she's found. Well, I'd pop a cap in Sancho and I'd slap her down. But I really wanna know, my baby. Said he'd pop a cap in Sancho and slap her down.
That's awful. I can't help but bob my head to it, though, but that is fucking awful.
Yeah.
Don't help, Brad.
Yeah. Yeah. Bradley, please. And then you're, like, dancing. Please stop don't. It.
Dickhead.
Yeah.
No, that's terrible.
And, like, he seems just like, you know, a loving guy that, like, if you betray him, he'll kill you.
He calls out his gun a couple times in songs. That's why I bought a gun.
He's like,
could this
22.
Just be a Rocky Raccoon situation? Rocky Raccoon, you know, went into a room. And he had a whole little showdown himself. And
he found Gideon's Bible.
Yeah. And he shot, and the other guy shot. And fucking
McGill, dude.
Yeah.
There's a lot of there's a lot of storytelling with Sublime. And, like, I feel like it doesn't always hit. And because, like, I don't know.
No, I agree.
to the same point, like, I don't know, like the song Date Rape, it's if you took out the lyrics or you couldn't understand what he was saying, it's just a boppy, like, pop ska song, you know?
Yeah, totally.
But, like, just because of the subject matter, it's like, dude, I don't want to fucking listen to this, you know? Like, it's
right.
Like, to bring awareness to it with that, like, immortalizing, like, a fucked up story in a song is
right.
Kind of.
And he's just going, like, na 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 na. It's like, dude, you're not taking this seriously, bro.
Yeah. That's and funny. You don't fight trauma with more trauma.
Yeah. Kick it up now. Kick it up now. Kick it up now. Yeah, dude.
Na 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 na.
Yeah. It's like, 1, 2, 3, day rape. Just like, oh my God. Please,
yeah, right?
Please. All right, so what about you? What is your Morrissey Award, Matt?
All right, so I got to say that originally I was looking at Date Rape or Wrong Way, right? But then I was okay, are they really fucking, at least Date Rape, is he saying he's date raping somebody or is this guy getting convicted at the end? Wrong Way, you know, it's kind of on the fence of whether he was condoning it, which in the end, yeah, maybe. But I thought, clear as day, April 29th, 1992. Okay, I'm talking. He's hit the liquor store and got all the alcohol he couldn't afford.
Yeah.
Fucking me, red lights flashing, time to retire. Then they turned that liquor store through a structure fire. Sounds pretty shitty, dude.
He's breaking the law.
Then they hit the music shop. It only took one brick to make that window drop. But nice. Yeah, so that's what I have to say right there.
That was
right.
Nice. Wow,
right.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, let me play a little bit of that.
Pro property, Matt.
Yeah, dude.
Look at dude, liquor store? Yeah, that's really owned by Walmart. Come on, bro.
You think you're fucking getting all that liquor?
Come on, dude. Somebody's mom and dad right there. Rooftop
yeah.
Korean.
Nothing like a fucking white guy telling you, yeah, I know it's about the black guys and the Mexicans, but it's actually just fucking
about everybody, man.
Yeah, hey, you don't. Yeah,
actually, everybody.
You guys don't really.
Let's play
the
song. Let's play the song.
Here we go.
April 26, 1992. There was a riot on the streets. Tell me, where were you? You were sitting home watching your TV. While I was parked, it's a beating, it's some anarchy.
First spot we hit, it was my liquor store. I finally got all that alcohol I can't afford. With red lights flashing, time to retire. And then we turned that liquor store into a structure fire. Next stop we hit, it was the music shop. It only took one to make that window drop.
Finally, one thing I do want to know, if you guys do know, why is it called April 29th, 1992, when the song says April 26th, 1992?
What
the fuck is that?
It took 3 days to come out that binge, man.
Oh, yeah. The riot, I mean, there was 3-day riot. That's when it started, 26.
Interesting, yeah, maybe that's when it started.
Nice.
Yeah. That's when it ended.
It started a day before my second birthday, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Coincidence?
Okay. Yeah.
I think not.
My party was so popping, dude.
Yeah, they're saying happy birthday, Leon.
My party was so popping, people couldn't get in.
The riot ended at your house.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, he brought everybody together.
He's 2 years old, y'all.
That song is pretty fun,
though. I went out to the streets and I said,
yeah,
stop this madness.
Said, National Guard.
you handed them Pepsis.
Yeah.
Everybody stopped.
Oh, man. Okay, so that was all of our Morrissey Awards. Let's get to the next award. This is the Are We Human or Are We Dancer Award. This is uncomprehensible lyrics, but this is the written word. What Bradley is actually saying in his songs, in his songwriting. I mean, this guy is an addict, so obviously he's going to be on some type of trip here and there. Does anybody have any kind of egregious ones to start with?
I've got like a weird one, I guess. I just like thought it was a weird lyric. Pawn shop at 145. He says, down there at the pawn shop, what has been told, albino made of stone, just remembered that it's flesh and bone. I don't get what that means, and it sounds really weird. And I also get a little bit Elizabeth Frazier, because it sounds like he says, just remember it's Rochambeau.
Albino made of stone. Just remember that it's flesh and bone.
This is probably a video I don't understand, but yeah. Weird lyric.
Weird lyric for sure.
Pipe talk, dude.
Yeah, no, maybe.
Flesh and bone.
Maybe.
Needles.
Maybe just some pirate stuff, dude.
Okay, interesting. Mm. Words from the pro. Maybe it's pirate stuff.
Maybe, man.
Professional opinion. Look up pirate stuff on this. All right, cool. So, what about you, Leon? What's your Are We Human, Are We Dancer award?
Mine's going to be STP at 130.
Mm.
I didn't know they were a big Stone Temple Pilot fans, dude.
Yeah. It's name droppers, dude.
Wrenching on my right. Get that secret pad where we hide. There's always lots of fun stuff to do, like relax and design a brand new tattoo. Play with my crossword puzzle book. I'm even learning how to cook.
Yeah, like what the fuck?
No new hobbies, Leon.
Yeah, dude.
I do what I do.
Yeah.
What is this guy? This guy just go through a quarantine or what?
Yeah. Where's the baking bread part of the song? Yeah, dude.
Where's the sourdough?
Yeah. Yeah. That kind of remind me of like that one song that Blondie did. That like show tunesy type of song.
Oh yeah, I forget which one that's called.
Oh
yeah.
God, yeah.
Nice callback, guys. You guys don't know what it is.
Too faded. Cool. Too faded to remember the song name, but you know what? I have a good memory. My mom says I got a good memory.
What?
All right, so do you have one? Are you an Are We Dancer Award, Matt?
Yeah, after you, if you want to go
first.
Well,
I don't have one. Okay. That's what I was going to say.
Matt, take it.
So go ahead,
I got
Matt.
One. Okay, so Hope, right? I don't know when, but I can damp on the. I'll say this lyric. And then
okay, you just put I'll just play some random time.
So now you wait for his cock, you know it will turn you on. He's going to make you feel the way you want to feel. When he starts to lie, when he makes you cry, you know I'll be there. I didn't like that lyric very much. It was very little. Come on, Bradley.
Bradley's a cuck, dude.
He's an incel.
Yeah.
Fucking incel.
He fucks. What are you talking about?
He's a cuck.
He's just
dude.
Jealous, dude. And maybe he's a cuck for fun, you know, like with one relationship. Okay, so let's do that. I'll try this random time.
I didn't know you and Bradley were such homies. You fuck.
We haven't fucked, but we've been in the same room.
It's hard to stay up when you're on H, right?
And Martini was there too, dude.
From what I hear, dude.
Shout out to Martini.
Yeah, here we go.
She
you don't stand a chance. So now you wait for us talking, oh, it will turn you on. Oh, he's gonna make you feel the way you are a man. When he starts to lie, when he makes you cry, you know I'll be there. My day will come. I know someday.
That's some obsession shit. Sorry, we're not
yes,
supposed to talk to him.
That's some obsession
who
shit.
Who wants
just like
to
you said,
tell him?
Oh, you tell him, Josh.
Oh, shit. Tell
it's
me.
A cover.
Yeah.
A
cover?
Yeah,
it's
oh,
a cover of the
shit.
Descendants, yeah.
Yeah.
But, damn. I mean, he wanted still to record. He used fucking free studio time to put that in there.
Yeah. That's crazy. Yeah. Good for him. That's a
it
long
was a
album.
Cover, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
We do still a, really do a few up. Covers, yeah.
I'm not covering that song.
No.
I'll be the only one.
Day will come.
That's why, yeah, like, why, you know, fuck that.
He's just at home. He's like,
I'm gonna
his
wait.
Dick probably feels so good.
Okay, so yeah, I did not do a Are We Human, Are We Dancer award, but whoa. I chose to do something else. I chose to do a Grand Theft Audio award.
Whoa.
This is a song that is just like a rip of another band or a genre that they just like, you know, it's too apparent, and I think for us, it's too close to what happened last episode. So this is a song called Cisco Kid that they did. It's basically kind of like a hip-hop, like Beastie Boys thing, but it feels just like a little bit, it's like their earlier days, like minimal type of beat, and then just like heavy samples. And it's not a terrible song. I just feel like they're ripping off like straight from Beastie Boys, like the vein of Beastie Boys, you know?
What's your name?
Cisco Kid.
Si. Pancho's name is Pancho.
Now in 94 we got an STP. A half pack of smoking. Oh yes, Sam B. A 15 pack of old Milwaukee. A Dalmatian and a girlfriend, but I ain't got no money. The 808 is within my reach.
So you hear the guitar, bam, bam, right?
Mm-hmm.
You hear the keyboard. It's bad Beastie Boys. It's not good Beastie Boys. I was listening to it and I was like, dude, like this sounds like an outtake of Beastie Boys. Like if they were trying to have fun, but yeah. Like they were like, oh, this sucks. Don't put it on, you know? And like Bradley's just doing like kind of like more of like a dub vocal, but like the actual lyrics are like, I'm having a Milwaukee. You know, like
very like a Beastie Revolution. You're
exactly.
thinking
exactly. It's yep. just like dude drinking beer, like being a shithead, and yeah, that's my Grand Theft Audio. It's a little too close. They do a lot of homage, and like they do a lot of covers.
They sample Beastie.
And they sample the right? Beastie Boys yeah. in the
oh,
first
really?
Record.
What song?
It's called like Slow Ride or something like that.
Yeah, at the very end, at the very end, it's just like a very like small
yeah.
Snippet.
It's the very last moment of. Mm-hmm. Slow Ride, yeah.
And they're, like, creating, like, this has to be around Check Your Head era.
Right.
You know?
So, they're referencing them, for sure, in this song. But, yeah, definitely just, like, two on the nose for me. And so that's why I'm giving this... I don't know if I've given this before, this award, but this is the Grand Theft Audio Award.
GTA. I feel like you have. That sounds
right.
Very,
I feel
very
like
funny.
I have at least once before.
Yeah.
All right, cool. All right, so that is the Are We Human, Are We Dancer Award. Mm-hmm. Let's go to the Hidden Gems. This is the second favorite, something you discovered or rediscovered during this listen. So it's a song that you really like, maybe your second favorite song, we'll call it that, you know? You want to go first, Matt?
Yeah, I rediscovered Don't Push. I looked at that, and I was like, damn, I missed that song. And I listened to it twice.
I missed that song.
I missed it.
And we got there together. You are, friend.
Yeah, hi.
Don't
How
Push.
You been?
Can't find a rhyme and I wanna start some static, but I can't afford this slander to the ground like I fall off my skateboard. Hey, nowadays it's clear as you please. Get strapped with protection or strapped with disease. Laughter, it's free. Anytime, just call me 439-0116. When you die with Sublime, you get funky pressure.
I take it back. I don't know if it was a different version, but that doesn't feel like the song I remembered.
That's on 40 Ounces to Freedom. I don't know. Is it? Are you looking for the first album version?
You try know, that I didn't even...
I really hope Anthony Kiedis has heard that song.
Oh, he has.
I really, really...
He's like, absolutely.
Fucking fresh.
Play the beginning.
The music goes on night and it goes.
I think that's the one. Maybe. Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, so this is the first album version.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay,
Jah Don't Pay the Bills?
Yeah, here we go. This is off Jah Don't Pay the Bills.
If I was Mike Tyson, I would look for a fight. And if I was a boomtown rat, I would be staying up all night. If I was a king of rock, I would be stupid and dumb. And if rhymes were body arms, I'd be comfortably numb. But if I had a shotgun, you know what I'd do? I'd point it straight up at the sky and shoot heaven on down to you. Because the bars around me open, and the time is always right, and if God's good word goes unspoken, the music goes on.
Feels different. Feels like it was a different song. It's a different song. I don't know what you got, shit, kind of computers you got over.
Stop
there.
Hiding the song.
What kind of Spotify play you're playing on?
Stop fucking around.
Some prank shows and some comedy. Yeah, Ashton, or something?
Ashton, get the fuck out of here.
I swear to God, that's dude, fine. There's no that's... other versions, man.
I did.
Yeah, I just listened to some fake version.
That was a high school band covering that on YouTube.
He's like, don't speak. It's there's a girl singing in it. I don't know why it's different. Okay, so that's yours, right?
All
right,
yeah, we'll just say this.
Okay, well, what about you,
Leon? I'm going to go with KRS-One. I've never heard this song before, and it was good.
Nice. Oh, yeah.
That was fun.
Nice selection.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yeah.
Norman. The producer.
School, they never taught about hamburgers or steak. Elijah Muhammad or the welfare state. But I know. And I know because of KRS-One. Yeah, and I know. And I know because of KRS-One. Because he's dropping science, chopping history with a whole leap of style and intelligence. Yes, I know.
It's just fun. It's
yeah,
funny.
It's good. It's very good.
It's very cute.
Yeah,
it's a
just
cute
like a
song.
Like a sick ass, like he just likes KRS-One and wrote this dude a song.
It reminds me of that acoustic cover of Boys in the Hood. Mm-hmm. Who does that? I don't know.
Dynamite Hack, dude.
Yeah.
It does. It does have a little thing like that, yeah.
Voice of our generation, dude. Dynamite Hack.
And this album has a lot of songs, and I think Josh's like whole thing about how they had to sneak in to record, like they recorded this song just like probably like middle of the night, 3 a.m.
on fucking meth, just like
twacked out of their brain, dude. I know. It is a little like Animal Collective in that way. They used to, you know. Okay, interesting. That's a good one. Yeah, I was thinking about that one too.
It barked.
Yeah, that's
my... that was my animal collective.
So your animal is a dog.
Guys, I'm doing song tongs.
Yeah,
that's some song tongs for you.
The bees. Okay, what about you, Josh? What is your hidden gem?
Hidden gem. I have Steppin' Razor at 105. Doesn't sound like a lot of their stuff, and I like it.
This is my for a while. I just took it off my list today.
Well, I found it after you discarded it. Mm-hmm. I was like, Leon.
Mine was the intro though.
Of course. I think it's true. Yeah.
Watch my side.
Sucking on my titties cause you're
Peaches.
Like Peaches, dude.
No, you know who it is? It's fucking Ween, dude.
Whoa.
It's Ween is who it is.
Oh, hit that God, hit that intro. Dude. The intro's fucking wild too.
The intro? Hold on. Intro for Leon.
Yeah, please. Give me that mainline me.
The intro for the pro. Here we go.
George Lopez? I like it.
This is the start of Do It Again, dude.
That's there we go.
Sick, yeah. That fat ass 808.
It's very cool. That's a nice song. I also
chomp on that one.
Thought about that as a hidden gem. but
pretty interesting that you've thought about all these songs, you know.
There's obviously not that. Well, I mean, no, there's a lot of songs, but it's only three albums.
Right. I landed on one that was also on 40 Ounces to Freedom. Scarlet Begonias.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
I had never heard this song before. If I had, I had never like known the name of it, you know. But pretty good song. Let's check it out.
She had rings on her fingers and bells on her shoes, and I knew without asking she was into the blues. She wore scarlet begonias tucked into her curls. I knew right away she was not like other girls.
Yeah, really fun song. Not really like what they do. They have like a different cadence of like the way they sing in that, which is really just like kind of poppy and like goofy.
40 Ounces is probably the funnest album, I'll say.
Yes.
You know?
100%. I think, you know, not later on, you know, we have a skippable song, but there's like a good amount of the last album that I think is just like, oh, like we need songs to fill this album. And they kind of added a lot of songs that... not my favorite songs,
but I feel like that's their biggest album is the last one. Mm-hmm. You know, like every single song,
it's a game of volume, I think, with them.
Yeah,
you know, you add a lot of songs, there's five hits, but then like, you know,
you think, I feel like off of the last album, like they're all like big songs for the most
they're
part.
All hits.
Like, well, like 70%, like 75%.
But it's their last album, and then like he died already, so
right, I mean, okay. The Ballad of Johnny Butt, Burritos, Under My Voodoo.
Well, Burritos, you know, I know. Like, I didn't know that song was called Burritos. I had heard that song before.
You know, like, a lot of those songs just, like, feel like they were tacked on because they were already recorded. And, like, you know, the more the merrier at that point, right? Yeah. Like, you need more.
Can't make more at that point, so here's what you got.
Exactly.
They're lo-fi records. They're lo-fi albums, like, the first one and the four-track recorded one.
Mm-hmm.
What is it? What's it called?
Robin the Hood.
Robin the Hood are the most fun ones because they do some crazy stuff. He just does like the wildest stuff on those.
They're exploring.
Yeah,
they're exploring their sound. He's like I think I said it. Like, he's a good songwriter. I'll say it. Like, I like his songwriting. I think he's fun. I think he knows how to like weave a tale. You know, like these songs have lasted the test of fucking time. You know, like from a shitty local Long Beach band to like being like this big for this long. Like, dude has something about his songs, and he's good, and I can admit that for sure. At least now I can, you know. So that's all of our hidden gems.
Yeah.
Right. Let's be a little more mean to them from here.
Jump
on
back
out.
On them.
Right. Jump back on them. Dogpile. This is the Kurt Cobain Repeat Offender Award. This is something where they're repeating ad nauseum, either like a lyric, a riff. You know, a way that he sings or something, just basically like a song that repeats too much.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna do this one.
Leon, go for it.
I'm gonna go with the most unnecessary song in the whole all their discography is "When I Got Reprise."
Oh.
What can I say?
Are you saying that just them putting it there is? Repeat
just,
offender.
Yeah, just no necessary. It's just like a reprise. It's the most unnecessary reprise.
And it just proves my point, right? Like, why are they adding this to an album? Like, it's just padding at this point, right?
Because I feel like probably because he had passed away and they were like, we've got this recording of him.
Yeah,
and like,
right. Or to maybe Josh's earlier award, they knew their fandom was really into like rapping and freestyling, so they gave him an instrumental to rap and freestyle over, where like Bradley wasn't doing his thing. You know,
our man here, our guest, is a rapper. So
wow.
No, but here's the question, guys.
No. Are you a rapper?
Just before anything here about Bradley and what I got. Why did he record it again? You gotta think about that. Why did he record it again if not to be on the album? Maybe it wasn't.
He could have fucked up. He could have been like, "I'll come back." When
but
I'm
are
not.
You are you a rapper?
I'm the best rapper. No, I'm not a rapper. I'm not a rapper.
Yeah, you guys remember. I'm an artist.
Yeah.
All right, let's play a little bit of What I Got Reprise.
Mm-hmm.
hard to love the one you got, cause you might get run over or you might get shot. Never had to battle with my bulletproof vest, never start static, I get it off my chest. Take a small example, a tip from me, take all of your money, give it up to charity. That's what I got within my reach.
What more jazzy in this version?
A different me.
So, like, I guess it's meant for you to just background vocals, because the background vocals are taken out, but his original vocals are left in.
Oh,
what a waste of a fucking song. You're right, Leon.
Interesting.
Yeah.
This is a so bad...
repetitive.
Yeah.
So that's not Cobain.
Very good. Very good. Josh, what about you?
My repeat offender is Jailhouse at 316.
And on my guitar, I had to be there, I had to be there, I had to be there, I had to be there. Oh, when I was a kid, it was the best day of my life. We had the 89 vision, we didn't fuss and no fight, when all the little knockers want to be my life. When that rhythm, it was playing on my guitar, I had to be there, 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 I had to be there.
Is he like, is this a memento sort of situation? Yeah. Where he was like, I had to be there.
Dude is not
I was there. Yeah. The rhythm was on my guitar.
I swear to God.
I swear, I had to be there.
Psychotic break. Dude.
You weren't there, Bradley. Yeah.
That song's pretty cool, though.
I had to be there.
Yeah, I mean, it's a fun song for sure. But
definitely,
yeah,
repetitive.
The I had to be there part for sure got to me after, like, I listened to this a few times.
If you're paying attention to the lyrics, I can see it. But if you're just like jamming out to it,
I can't understand.
You just gotta learn how to jam, dude. Just like fill the track.
You've said that before, is that like, just don't listen to the lyrics. I'm like, yeah, man, I can't listen to it without noticing the lyrics.
All right, I'm going to go next real quick, and then I'll let you go last, Matt. Okay, so mine is going to be, for the Kurt Cobain Repeat Offender Award, We're Only Gonna Die for Our Arrogance. This is off of 40 Ounces to Freedom.
And I walked away as my man took control. Their minds weren't all the same, and to conquer was their goal. So he built his great empire, and he slaughtered his own kind.
That's the whole song.
Wow.
That's everything. They do that like 6 times. They start off slow, they get a little faster, they get a little faster.
Yeah.
At the very end, they go very fast. So that's the entire fucking song.
Yeah.
Right there. It's pretty
six times
dumb,
or something,
dude.
Like you said.
It's so dumb. We're only gonna die for our arrogance. Yeah. Don't worry about that song. If you're listening and you're in a hurry, you can skip it. I'm not saying it's skippable, like the most skippable, but like,
yeah,
just like hearing that, like I was listening and I was like, okay, cool first intro, and then it like evolves and it gets a little faster, and I was like, oh cool, and then it gets a little faster but it doesn't change, and I was like, okay, and it's just the same thing.
So if you've heard the first 10 seconds, you heard the whole song.
You're good. You're good. You don't need any more.
Just stick to your arrogance and skip it.
Yeah. Yeah, let them die for their arrogance. All right, so what about you, Matt? What is your Kurt Cobain Repeat Offender Award?
I got a Down in the Pawn Shop. A lot of Down in the Pawn Shop.
Oh, yes.
Yep.
Where?
Down really, really shop. Messed up with Pawn Stars not making this a theme song.
Dude, that would be so good.
Swing and a miss.
Chun Li just coming through with smoke. They probably tried.
Yeah.
Try to get couldn't the rights. Do it, yeah.
Here we go.
Shop down there at the pawn shop. If it's not in stone, down there at the pawn shop. There's no way to shop down there at the pawn shop. What has been told? A pile of made of stone. Just remember that it's flesh and.
Yeah, down at the pawn shop.
Repetitivo.
Yeah. Just eat that, Macklemore.
Just remember, it's Rochambeau.
Yeah, that is Rochambeau. Yeah, repetitive as fuck.
Mm-hmm.
Unnecessary, for sure. But let's get to the most unnecessary song that they have.
Just yeah. start the fucking rocket, man.
The most skippable.
Getting ready to fucking go to Mars.
Launch this shit to space.
A song that you don't want to be ever recorded. You want to go back in time with Marty McFly and tell him, hey, Doc.
Yeah, you want to break up their parents.
Stop. Yeah, you want to make this song invisible. Doc. Turn it invisible. Send it to fucking Mars. And who wants to go first? We're going to have you go last, of course, Matt.
Okay.
I'll go first because mine was already said.
Ooh.
Mary.
Oh, okay. Yes. For the weird,
I just think incest-y. Like the lyrics are lame. His voice is really like whack on that one. And I don't know. Within the album, I just feel like I just was not fucking with it. Because, again, I feel like the albums, even though they're pretty, like, dubby, heroin-y, chic type shit, you know what I mean? They're more or less pretty coherent. But this one I just was not fucking with.
Yeah, totally. You got time for that?
No, I don't have
time. Right, must be a random time. Here we go.
Please don't fuss and fight. You've heard the line before. Mary, baby, please don't think I'm poor. If you come home to me, turn off the lights and lock up the doors and start getting busy. I don't know if I can go so far up inside you.
Snoozeville, dude.
It just seems like a demo.
Yeah.
It just seems like a demo that he never finished, that they're like, come calling back to Little Rivers. It sounds like that Butterfly song, dude.
Dude,
save it for... fucking psycho trapping a butterfly in a jar.
Save it for Rivers, save it for Daniel Johnston, mm-hmm. save it for Elliot Smith. Just,
yeah. No. Put it on a demo tape. Don't put it on an album. Absolutely. For sure, skippable. Agreed.
Skip.
What about you, Leon? What is your most skippable song? What song are you sending to fucking... Mars.
Caress Me Down.
Whoa.
This guy doesn't like handjobs.
Are you kidding me?
This fucking guy doesn't like handjobs. Hey, everybody. Skippable fans.
I don't like the... Like,
Leon
the,
doesn't like handjobs.
I don't like the... Yo me llamo Casey. Bandana with me. I hate like that. I don't know. I think it's just goofy.
Oh, you got time for that?
Just anywhere.
All right, here we go. Yo, muñeca, if you're still standing still and we fall, caress me down, and that's the loving sound. We go, and the girl caress me down, and that's the loving sound. I think the music saves it for me.
Whew.
I think it saves it for me. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I like hand jobs. On the record.
Yeah.
Put me on the record, judge.
Song made me pretty horny.
Yeah, I was horned up, and I was like, who is this girl? She's a woman now, I'm sure. This is 30 years later. She probably is more experienced.
Kung fu grip.
Yeah, she's got the kung fu grip.
That sounds painful.
This fool busted in like 3 seconds. This is about premature ejaculation.
She's gotta be good.
Yeah. I think she literally just squeezed his nuts until like cum came out.
Dude. Okay, all right.
That's the kung fu grip.
It was in the club. It was actually blood.
Yeah, exactly. Good. Yeah. Caressed him down. Please. What is it, super bad? Okay, another great song. I will go next. My most skippable is the aforementioned The Ballad of Johnny Butt.
Oh, that's a good skip.
I mean, I think I haven't heard a song where it was a ballad of somebody and it was like a fantastic song. I think most songs that are the ballad of are somewhat kind of mid, if not terrible.
Ballad of Curtis Long?
Maybe. I'll play it next. And if it's good, I'll eat my crow right in front of everybody, okay? But here's the Ballad of Johnny Butt.
Shit won't matter. So shoot it up. Shoot it up. Just don't matter when you're resisting anyway. We got writing names, all we got to overcome.
It's just bad, dude.
And it also sounds like he's like, guys, we should really help my friend with his drug problems.
Yeah. He's just saying shoot up like it doesn't matter. His name's Johnny Butt.
He needs help.
Johnny Butt. So stupid, dude. What a dumb name, dumb song. the Ballad of Johnny Butt, you know, he's not going to go down in history as a good song. It's going down in history as the first ballad to ever be put on Mars, okay?
First ballad.
Is the Martian ballad, okay? All right, so finally we have our guest, Matt. What is your most skippable song from the Sublime discography? All right,
I mentioned it before for a different one, for a different award, but Hope. Hope I would skip. I don't even hear it. And I know it's not their song. Whose song is it?
Mm-hmm. Descendants.
I'd skip it there too.
So you're skipping the entire song.
Descendants and Sublime.
The writers of this song should be skipped.
Skip the writers. Get them help. Find those guys.
Seriously. Yeah. I mean, thankfully there's Tinder and stuff now because, geez Louise, can you imagine just these freak incels? Just imagine. Yeah, they've got like one picture from like the company picnic her like turned the other way. Like, oh.
Psycho, dude.
All right, here we go. Hope.
I'll be the only one. So now you wait for a spark, you know it will turn you on. He's gonna make you feel the way you wanna feel. When he starts to lie, when he makes you cry, you know I'll be there. My day will come. I know someday I'll be the only one. Call it selfish, call it what you like. I think he's right. He wasn't worth it all you own and I'm
sure. He was a nice guy.
Yeah, true.
And like, this is not what they're good at or what they're known for, so easily skip.
Yeah, huge skip. You know, that's a good one.
Like, it just doesn't make any sense in their discography, and it's a cover, so like, it's not theirs, it doesn't belong to them, and it really doesn't belong in their discography.
Mm-mm.
All these songs skippable, dude.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Get the fucking Martians ready, dude.
Get the rockets ready.
We got a big old pile of shit coming.
LBC is going to hit the beaches, the shores of the Martian beaches.
The meth is coming, boys.
Yeah.
The meth is coming,
PCP. Boy. They sell all kinds of stuff, dude. Ecstasy, I think, as they say in the song. Okay, so that is all of the awards. Let's get to the final question. This is a huge one. Is Sublime, as a whole, skippable? Let's go around the table. We always got to ask the pro first.
The pro.
Professional opinion. Leona Cortez, what do you think about this? Skippable or not skippable?
As a Southern California native, you can't skip.
Whoa. Hmm. Not skippable.
You can't skip. Like you're saying it's inescapable. You're always going to hear.
So it's not skippable.
What I got.
It's ingrained in your upbringing.
I'll agree to not that. Not skippable. It's part of like everything that I grew up around, honestly, like skateboard punks in Southern California.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm fucking skipping, guys. I'm not gonna listen to any of this, honestly, after this. And it's not that I think it's bad. I can like, you know, remove myself enough to be like, oh yeah, like he was tripping out and like what he did he was good at and he's an artist in his own right. I'm not going to fucking listen to this.
But you're not going to listen to it on the radio?
I don't listen to the radio. I just listen to reruns of the skippables.
I am doing what I've done for the past 30 years. I am switching as fast as humanly possible.
Ka-doink.
Switch.
Yep.
Sorry, Jack FM. Not getting me this time.
Yeah, 88.7, please.
100% skippable, dude. Here's the thing about this band. I appreciate them and I respect them. I think they are a good band. Mm-hmm. They have been ruined. They have been destroyed. They have been wrecked.
Rome.
This is like Grateful Dead level. This is like Fish. This is like Nickelback level of fan. Like if anybody was like, oh, I love Nickelback, people are just gonna shit on you. They're gonna hate you.
But those bands suck though.
Right.
This is at least was fun. They had some fun songs.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. Well, when we do our Nickelback episode, we might have to be reassessing that, Leon. Who knows?
I don't know. Going again, I don't know how much I hate them. I just like truly am not going to... I know myself, and I'm not going to go back to Badfish, even though it's my top op. You know?
Yeah.
I'll hear it on the radio or whatever, but...
I'll sing it on karaoke.
Mm. Yes.
Get me drunk enough, I'll sing it.
Yeah. I'm skipping just because I think, like Leon said, it is inescapable. So why bother going out to listen to it when you're going to hear it at the local bar anyway? So, like...
Fucking edgelord over here, huh?
It's true, though.
You know, it's the truth. Like, you're going to hear it regardless. So there's no point in, like, putting on a playlist. Like, the life is going to put it on its own playlist, and you're going to hear it, you know? So what about you, Matt?
You cannot skip this band. Cannot skip. I don't know what the official skippable award exactly means. Like, don't put it on a playlist, or if you've never heard it, should you take a listen once? Yes, you cannot skip. This should be at least checked in at once. Maybe not listened to over and over again, depending on what your feels are. But should you skip it? No.
This is a great, great question that I think we should maybe start answering, because we ask, is it skippable? And we say, yes, no, okay, yeah. Is it bingeable? I think that's another question. And I think the answer in this case is yes. I think you could binge this.
Yeah, I think this is super bingeable.
You guys are weird.
It's three albums.
It's not that much.
And I think it's like 3 hours. I think each album is just an hour or slightly over.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it all is one pretty solid sound, even though it's like eclectic in its own way.
It's fun. Like Bradley having fun doing different things. I think you could put this like at a party and people would like front to back all three albums. I don't think it'd be like a bummer. I think people would be pretty cool with it, especially in the LA area, SoCal area. So skippable, but bingeable. Wow. Yes.
Well, that's cute, guys.
Yes. I know, I like that.
Wow.
All right.
Yeah, that was a moment that we just had. Okay, so that is all we have for the awards, all we have for the questions. Matt, we want to thank you so much.
Before we go, we have a pro tip, everybody. So this, coming from a little more on the reggae part of Sublime, here's some choices that I think kind of comparable. They do a Melodians song, but this isn't the song we're playing. So hit it, Joe.
Start?
Yeah. Hit it.
You have called me, baby. You have called me. I'm falling in love with you. So there ain't nothing left for you to do.
Yeah, so but to love me. Rivers of Babylon. That's the band, original band. And then also just the specials. So this is a special second album, but yeah, just reminding me a lot of Sublime, just from England though. Ever change. Tips, everybody.
Yeah, those are pretty good. Pro yeah, tips. Those are super good. I like both of those. Very like Clancy Eccles.
Yeah. I don't know what you're talking about. What?
Look up Clancy Eccles, What Will Your Mama Say? Because it sounds exactly like that first song. But yeah, super good.
You know, Josh, I'm the pro on this pod.
I wasn't saying anything. You can still be the pro
on this pod. Yeah.
Look, I'm just the assistant. He's like, hey, boss, check out Clancy.
All we talk about is wedding plans. Those things belong in the stand.
Yeah, dude.
What will same. Your mama say?
The same rhythm.
Mm-hmm. Yep. It's so good.
That's an infamous Jamaican style, just the same rhythms over and over again.
I read somewhere that Bradley took a trip with his dad to the Virgin Islands, and that's what sparked everything. Yeah.
Wow. Dude. So thank the Wright brothers for this, for Sublime.
It all comes back to the Caribbean.
Incredible. Yeah, so what an episode. What a tip. What a few tips that we had there.
I'm going to stay in my lane next time.
Trident over here. Yeah, I like it. But yes, Matt, thanks again for bringing Sublime to the table, letting binge them. They're really fun.
Thank you, guys. This has been fun. Thank you for listening.
Anything you want to plug to our listeners?
I want
to
plug the Talking Book for some of your philosophical needs. We like to read nice little quotes on that page for your mornings, afternoons, or evening thoughts. Check it out.
Where at?
On TikTok. Yes. At the Talking Book.
All right. Anywhere else? Just that?
Just that.
Just that.
Check out the TikTok, y'all.
Yeah, dude, TikTok. Big one. Big TikTok.
Big TikTok.
Big TikTok.
Big TikTok. Big TikTok.
Big TikTok things. TikTok.
Okay.
It's cool.
Check them out.
Thanks for coming on.
You will be smarter.
I appreciate you guys. Thank you.
Yeah. Once again, you've proven to be one of the best guests we've ever had. They're going to ask you on for another time pretty soon.
I'm sure.
Don't think about it. I'll think about it.
Stop. Thank you, guys.
Leon will book you. But yeah, thanks again, everybody. Don't let the world skip you by.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Toodaloo.
Goodbye.